everybody. We're going to talk to you about how to prep the salad in a jar. We're going to send out this document soon that gives you the step-by-step details. This is what we commonly do for lunch. It's just a really quick way to prep good veggies that can be different really every day of the week. You can change the protein. So we're just going to go through how to do this. So basically what I did is I went to Walmart actually and got all of these ingredients, including the mason jars, which are quart size. And then I just bought the veggies that I was kind of in the mood for. It would be easier if they have a selection of cut up vegetables, but Walmart did not have that. But they did have a lot of organic stuff that I was able to get at like a really cheap price. So it was actually, it looks really pretty color wise. So what we're gonna do is walk you through it step by step. These are some finished ones that we already did here. So here, what you're gonna do, always add the dressing first. That's the most important part. I'm gonna send you some suggestions for some clean dressings. Of course, olive oil and vinegar works really well, but if you wanna do a pre-made one, we're using a Wild Tree one, but you can Tessa May's, Primal Kitchen, they all have really good, pretty clean dressings that are already made that I think taste pretty good. So you're gonna put in however much dressing you feel like you're in the mood for at the time. You could measure it if you wanted to just be using a tablespoon or something like that, but I didn't feel like doing that, and so I just poured in what I felt like would look good at the time. Your hard veggies are gonna go next, and so radishes are always good for this layer because they're very hearty. So anything that you wouldn't mind sitting in the dressing for a while, that's gonna taste good when it soaked up its flavor. Jicama would be good. We're using cucumber here. Can you think of any other hard veggies that you like?
Like
use?
Cauliflower. I think cauliflower would be a good one. Maybe asparagus, stuff like that. You just want to keep in mind that it's going to be sitting there even up for like a couple of days. So just nothing that's going to get super soggy. So like broccoli might not be a super good one. Stuff like that.
Your crispier veggies are going to be good for this first layer. And then next you're going to do a little bit softer veggies. So we have a kind of a combo of nice bell pepper here. So you can just kind of choose. You wouldn't necessarily have to put all of these in if you wanted to do different colors for different days. But I kind of like the color. It's very visually appealing to me. So just as much as you want to add to that layer. And really the only limiting factor is how much room you have in your jar. So you could add as much or as little of each veggie as you wanted. The next layer, which we don't actually have here, would be softer veggies like tomatoes and olives.
Or like a hard-boiled egg.
Yeah. Like that. Yeah, so that would work here. Anything that you feel like might get soggy pretty easily would go in that layer. We talked about avocado, so if you wanted to add avocado first, you could squeeze some lemon or lime over it if you felt like it would go well with the rest of your stuff there, because it might turn brown if it's been sitting there for a while, but to me, that's not a big deal to me, but to other people.
Yeah, I like my avocados green, so I would totally put some lime on there.
Yeah, which I think would still taste pretty good. So then you next layer would basically be your greens. As long as you've got your dressing, you've got your hard veggies, your softer veggies, and then you've got even maybe a little bit of softer protein there, like your boiled eggs. Then next we would add the greens. Greens are always going to be kind of your last layer. So those would go on top because we don't want them to get soggy sitting in that dressing for a long time. So you want to add those last. The other thing you could add on top of those that would stay good would be nuts or seeds or something like that. Chia seeds, flax seeds, whatever you were kind of in the mood for would go on top of the greens. And then your protein is best, to me, added right before you eat it.
Yeah.
I know sometimes people will add it and just leave it in the jar, but I think you're better off maybe prepping your protein. You could even do protein out of the can, so salmon, tuna.
Chicken.
Chicken, if you could find like a clean chicken in a can, but chicken's pretty easy just to get a chicken breast and just kind of chop it up or whatever.
Grill it or bake it prior. Maybe have like a batch of chicken ready to go for all your salads.
Shrimp would be really good as a protein on here, some grilled shrimp. So there's really kind of, there's no limits to how you can make this different. So once you're done and you've got all your stuff you want in there, you basically just put the top on and store it in the fridge like this for up to about 3 to 5 days. And then when you're ready to eat it, you'll add anything extra like the protein, and then you just kind of dump it up and down so that the salad dressing infiltrates.
Just mixes well. And another note, you guys, is so we are actually using the wide mouth mason jars just because it's easier to kind of just throw everything in there, but just a little tip.
Yeah, so again, this is all kind of kind of up to you and how ease is going to go to cut up veggies, which veggies you want. But we'll send this in a document so you know layering. But the most important thing about layering is your dressing is going to be at the bottom and the greens always at the top. So that's it. We'll send out a complete document so you can see what to do yourself.